All right, without further ado, I'd like to say giving all praises to Yahweh, the Father, Wah, Yahweh Shai, the Son. Also give a double honors to the elders of GMS, double honors to the Achaim. Peace and blessings, brothers and sisters that listen. And who we out here for? You Israelites, man. You so-called Negroes, you Hispanics, and you Native American Indians. All right? We out here to warn you what's about to come to America. Destruction and death on all sides, man. All right? And to bring you back to your nationality and tell you how to escape these things, man. The impending doom that's about to come on this society. All right? Martial law, the chip, race riots, that economy crashing, famine. All right? There's also going to be a famine of the word, too, man. And also, this weather's unusual. In February, the coldest month of the year. 60 degrees, man. So these are all signs of the times. You know, and you also got brothers being persecuted. You know, and that's just a part of the truth, man. You know, I could even see it on the comment boards, the comments that people write. Which in times past, we would entertain that. Now, we don't got the time for that. If people want to remain in darkness, remain in darkness, man. The Most High is going to justify us anyway. All right? He always did. I'm going to read the first precept. Philippians chapter 4, verse 1. We don't got to justify ourselves, man. The Lord going to do that. Right. Philippians 4 and 1. Practically changed precept. See, the white man, when he come up here, he look at that sign. Their handiwork, and they always walk away. Alright. Where was that? There we go. Philippians chapter 4, verse 1. That's what the Apostle Paul said. We on?
Beautiful.
Alright. Therefore, my brethren, dearly beloved, and long for my joy and crown. And this is what he said. So stand fast in the Lord, my dearly beloved, man. Paul said to what? To stand fast. How do we stand fast? By coming out on the highways and hedges. When it's cold or when it's hot. The scripture says be instant in season means be ready. In season and out of season. Hell, we didn't even really have a out of season this year. Because the weather's been so unusual, man. But that's all glory to Yahweh Shimei Al-Shah. Because this word going to come out, man. Most High made the weather beautiful this year, man. We didn't even have much of a winter. Which is also a sign of the time. Alright, let me read on. Let me jump down to the point. Verse 4. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again I say rejoice. Let your moderation be known unto all men. The Lord is at hand. That's the point I wanted to bring out in that whole scripture, man. The Most High is at hand, alright? He's about to send his son back to judge this planet Earth, who you ignorantly call Jesus Christ, Yahweh Shai. And he forewarned us the things that's written up in this book, what to look out for. Obviously, the majority of people out here, they can't see it because they're under gross darkness, man. The scripture tells you that in Isaiah, the 60th chapter, that gross darkness was going to cover the Earth. I see got homosexuals out here, transgenders. See what I'm saying? That demon is at an all-time high. All right? You got demons attacking brothers, man, on a common board. You know what I'm saying? Dudes that supposedly know the truth. All right? But that don't bother us, man. You guys are in your lot, man. okay, because everything was already predetermined. We just got like the Paul, Pastor Paul said, I'm going to read it again. Philippians chapter 4, verse 5. Let your moderation be known unto all men. The Lord is at hand, man. And Yahweh Shai is going to destroy America, man. Right along with the nuclear missiles in the third world war. And we're approaching that, man. The Lord is at hand. So what do we got to do? Ecclesiastes chapter 39, verse 1. We got to prophesy, man. We don't got time to play games, man. These people out here, they're done. They're finished. They're already sealed. The blood is off our hands. I'm talking to your Negro, Hispanic, and Native American. The white man and the other nations, they can do what they want. Okay, they're going to be destroyed regardless, man. All right? Ecclesiastes 39, verse 1. Ecclesiastes 39, verse 1. But he that giveth his mind to the law of the Most High. We do keep the law, statutes, and commandments to the best of our ability, of course. All right? Because you can't keep it perfect. Keep it to the best of your ability, and you have faith. Okay? And the way you're going to be justified is by your works. All right? What's the work? Coming out here, man. Publishing this word openly. Okay? Whatever your lot is, man. Verse 1. But he giveth his mind to the law of the Most High, and is occupied in the meditation thereof, will seek out the wisdom of all the ancients, and be occupied in prophecies. What are you supposed to be occupied in? Prophecy. That's a prophet's job, to say before what's about to happen, man. All right? Now we know according to the scriptures, the majority of times the prophets came out, the people never listened. The majority of people never listened. But the Heavenly Father always had a remnant on their leg that always took heed to those things. And I'm going to show that in the scriptures, man. What brothers is going through is nothing new. It happened to our forefathers in the past. Okay? Prophet after prophet came, and the majority of people always rejected them. Okay? That's just how it's set up. And of course, when the Lord came on the scene, our people did the same thing back then. And the Romans crucified him and put him to death. So he's an example for us to follow, man. Yahweh Shai, man. See, the Jesus that they teach in these churches, that's not the Jesus of the Bible, man. First of all, he was dark-skinned, a white woolly hair, and a white woolly beard. That whole white image, that was put up in the 1400s, man. And the philosophy, that Christianity that came along with it, is satanic. That's not of the Bible, man. That prosperity doctrine. The scripture talks about suffering, affliction, man. That's your baptism. Right? Matthew 10, 24. So the scripture said we got to be occupied in prophecy. And what's the main prophecy? America's destruction is at hand, man. Babylon is going to fall, man. So enjoy it. Okay, and this guy Trump is on fire. All right, he's a devil. That boy on fire, man. He's bringing the prophecies quick. He's not wasting any time. Why? Because that's the spirit of Yahweh Shemaiah Shah. The Most High is not wasting any time, man. He's speeding things up. The days are shortening as we speak. We're already about to be in March already, the third month of the year, man. Just like that. So time is flying. So we got to be what? On point. Like the Bible says, we got to be circumspect. Remain in the light. Be occupied in prophecy. Study. Examine yourself. Pray always, man. Read that, matter of fact. 1 Thessalonians 5:20. Alright. The Most High gave us this word. Let's run with it. Okay? Don't worry about these demons on the common board. Like, it's easy to cut them, guys, man. And we beyond that now. Alright, I'm gonna read scriptures on that. And these other demons in Israel, man. And these other agents that be out here as well. Oh. First Thessalonians. So Paul said, First Thessalonians chapter 5, chapter 5, verse 19. Quench not the spirit, man. Scripture says don't quench the spirit, man. Something comes in your mind, report on it. Like the Apostle Paul said in Philippians, the fourth chapter, man. Alright? Quench not the spirit. We in a time of prophecy, man. So you got to put videos up. You know, you got agents out here too. You got to put videos up. Come out here and prophesy, man. Teach in your spare time. You can't quench the spirit, man. Okay, publish this word, man, because we're coming to the end of this thing, man. America don't got that much time left, man. Okay, we coming to the last seconds of this empire, man. It's going to be war on all sides. Things is about to erupt in this country. Your life is going to change soon, man. That economy is going to crash, all right? Same thing that you have in Brazil, which I reported on through the spirit of Yahweh Hashem Yahushua, Mexico, Peru, Venezuela, India economy crash. They trying to deal with that, what, that cashless society, man. I think Modi said, well, 85% of their currency is no longer legal tender. Then you have that euro, all right? We know Trump, I heard him talking about gold the other day, man. So they what? They're trying to phase out the dollar. That's what it's coming to. Okay, that's what it's boiling down to, man. That RFID chip, all right? So let me read on. So the scripture says, quench not the spirit. Quench not the spirit, despise not prophesying. So what are you supposed to do? Prophesy, say before. That is our job, man. Okay? And the scripture says, whether people hear or forbid, go out there and do the work. And pray the Most High. I'm going to read that scripture actually. Read it again. Despise not prophesying, man. Okay, so you can't despise prophesy, all right? Prophesy a white man's destruction. Esau, Edom, and all the wickedness that he's been doing throughout the planet Earth and since his inception in this country, the rape, robbery, and murder, he's going to go down with fire, man, nuclear fire, all right? The Most High is going to raise up his people in the midst of the heathen, man. I'm going to read that, Micah chapter 5, verse 8. Micah chapter 5 verse, ooh, where we at? And the remnant of Jacob shall be among the Gentiles in the midst of many people as a lion among the beasts of the field, as a young lion among the flocks of sheep. So the remnant, even the two-thirds gonna get down. They just not gonna be saved. Alright? So it's gonna be a major race riot in this country. It's going to be a major race riot in this country, man. Major, man. And you Negroes and Hispanics and you Native Indians, a lot of you are going to die in that first round because you're so asleep. Okay, you couldn't hear the trumpet being blown to you, man. Okay, there's going to be a famine of the word real soon. We won't be able to come out here. Okay, when they got police troops everywhere, martial law, man. This word going to be, that's it.
Peace, man.
All right, Shalom. Okay, we not going to be coming out here no more, man. That means the Most High already sealed the elect. See, but y'all have not been paying attention, man. Okay, y'all still complain about this idiot Trump. You need to seek the Most High. Okay, you still fair man. And after he's done with this immigration, that welfare going to be next. You Negroes and Hispanics on that welfare, man. Especially these women. That's comfortable, man. Their life going to change. But I'm going to read Micah chapter 5. And the remnant of Jacob shall be among the Gentiles in the midst of many people, as a lion among the beasts of the forest, as a young lion among the rocks of the sheep. If they go through, both treadeth down and teareth in pieces, and none can deliver. So the Most High is going to put a crazy spirit on Jake. And they're going to come up against the white man, man, and these other nations, man. All right? That's what's coming to this society, man. Matter of fact, let me read 2 Ezra. 2 Ezra.
Awesome.
2 Ezra chapter 16. I haven't read this precept in a long time. 2 Ezra chapter 16. Let me see where we at. Gotta read the scripture.
So cool.
Oh man, it's
wicked, wicked.
2 Ezra chapter 16, verse 18. No, 19. Let me start from 22. Let me just, because that whole 2 Ezra, the 16th chapter, that's a bad scripture right there. And these people right here that you see walking up and down aimlessly without a clue in the world. Stuck in the matrix, all right? The matrix really means the womb, but it's a world that seemed real and it's not. That world is what? America, man. Because Babylon, America, has cast its vibe over the whole planet Earth.
All right.
I seen a brother in Kenya, which I'm gonna do video on. We're going to that now. Israelites are waking up everywhere, man. And he even said in Kenya, homosexuality has an all-time high. Why? Because of America. That's that witchcraft, man. See what I'm saying? But anyway, let me read. 2 Ezra chapter 16, verse 22. For many of them that dwell upon the earth shall perish of famine, and the other that escape the hunger shall the sword destroy, man. There's going to be a famine in America, man. The Bible says there's going to be a time on the planet Earth that the world has never seen before, man. But at that time, thy people shall be delivered. Which we're coming to that time right now. See? And dudes like that ain't going to make it, man. The scripture says, no effeminate shall enter the kingdom of the Most High, man. So you got Jake out here. That's what happens when you hang with the heathen, man. A damn botsy boy, man. Read on. It says, and the dead shall be cast out as dumb, and there shall be no man to comfort them. For the earth shall be wasted, and the city shall be cast down. And there shall be left no man to till the earth and to sow it. That's talking about what? The famine. Man. When the dollar collapses, you're going to have a famine out here. Okay? A dreadful famine. The people that's stuck in the inner cities, you're going to have it the worst. You're totally going to be closed in. The scripture says a man shall desire to go to another city, and he's not going to be able to, because it's going to be martial law, man. Okay? Read on. It says, verse 27, so that one man shall desire to see another and hear his voice. For of a city there shall be 10 left, and 2 of the field, which shall hide themselves in the thick roads and in the clefts of the rock. That's what's going to happen. See what I'm saying? This is what we're getting our minds to. Scripture said, remember this and show yourselves men. You gotta be a man in these times. Alright, read on. So like I said, the little tribulation that we're going through in the Scorpion this morning, we're reading what's going to happen to Scorpion this morning. Right in this precept right here. We're reading what's going to happen to these people that's comfortable in this society. Alright? It says, and the earth shall be laid waste. No, verse 31. Even so in those days, there shall be left three or four left by them that search their houses with the sword. So people going to go house to house killing people, man. Looking for food. Alright? How you doing? Shalom, shalom. Alright? You good?
No.
Alright? No questions?
You speak, I will ask you questions.
No problem. Read on. It says, and the earth shall be laid waste, and the fields thereof shall wax old, and her ways and her paths shall grow full of thorns, because no man shall travel therewith. The virgin shall mourn, having no bridegrooms. The woman shall mourn having no husbands. Their daughter shall mourn having no helpers. That's going to happen when the society collapses. The Most High is telling the prophet Ezra through the angel Uriel what was going to happen in the last days. And we can see that day approaching more and more and more. Okay? Like we said with Trump, with the whole immigration thing, is going to go past that. We're talking about summoning the National Guard. Going to get to welfare next. They're going to start cutting things on all sides. You're going to have crime increase, man. And eventually the dollar going to collapse. Because the majority of the world don't even like this guy, man. So America looking bad right now. But it's all the will of Yahweh Shem Yahushua. It's all the will of the Most High anyway. All right? Because this is his will. Read on. Hear now these things and understand them, ye servants of the Lord. Behold the word of the Lord, receive it. Believe not the gods of whom the Lord spake. And this is the point I want to bring out. Behold, the plagues draw nigh and are not slack. So the plagues are even closer than ever. Now you could even smell it. You could feel it in the air, man. Hell, like we said, this weather's unusual, man. Okay, things is just out of course. Things is abnormal in this time, man. And you being a servant of the Lord, a watchman, you're supposed to look out for everything and report it. Okay, unlike these false preachers, they don't teach anything, man. And that's why their congregation, they're going to be caught off guard. But let me read on. Behold, the plagues draw nigh and are not slack. As when a woman with a child in the ninth month bringeth forth her son, within 2 or 3 hours of her birth, great pains compass her womb. Which pain, when the child cometh forth, they slack not a moment. Even so, shall not the plagues be slack to come upon the earth. And the world shall mourn, and sorrow shall come upon it on every side, man. Bad times, man. Evil times, man. The Most High said plagues is drawn nigh upon the earth, and that the world shall mourn. Because this world is evil, man. And that's his doing. So when you see death on all sides, and you got people in Venezuela eating each other, which the American media never talk about, they have a major food crisis, man. Look up the top 10 dangerous cities in the world. Venezuela got like six of those, 10 of those cities are in Venezuela. They even started eating animals in the zoo because their currency fell. Right? So South America's on fire right now, man. And all that's going to happen here. All right? Now, we read on. This is what the Most High said. Oh, my people, hear my word. Make you ready to the battle. And in those evils, be even as pilgrims upon the earth, man. Because the pilgrims move from place to place. They didn't have any stable rest or stable residence. That's what the Heavenly Father's telling you to get ready. And when you going to see that? Where martial law happened. Okay? That whole getting the National Guard thing, that's just a prelude to martial law. That's basically what it is. Because they're going to lock down the city. Now, we've been saying this for the longest, you see? But that's just how the Most High get down. So when it really happens, when it comes down, people can't say, oh, I didn't know. Or I wasn't aware. You did know. Okay, you seen this out here. You seen this on the internet. The word spread throughout the internet, man. All right? What it is, people want to be entertained, man, with the Grammys and the Oscars and all kind of foolishness that really has no value. See, and that's how they keep these people asleep. It's easy to deceive these people. It's easy. It's child's play, man. The government laughs at these idiots out here, man. Because whatever they tell you in the media, which even had that demon Trump. You had that demon Trump, which he might be recording me, but even you had that demon Trump. They talking about the media is the enemy of the American people, which he is right about that, man. All right? He is right about that, man. Because most of the stuff they publish is garbage any damn way, man. And you people believe it, man. All right? Let me read on. Let me read that one more time and I'm going to move on. The Most High says, what? Oh, my people, hear my word. Make you ready to the battle, and in those evils, be even as a pilgrim upon the earth, man. So get ready. That's what the Most High is saying, man. Get your minds ready, man. All right? Because we're not going to be out here for too much long. All right? And the days is going fast. We're ready to march. All right? Stuff, major change has happened with this guy being in office. He's only been in office for about a month, or maybe a little bit over, maybe. And he has done things that other presidents haven't even done within even a year, man. Building the wall, immigration ban, want to get the National Guard for you immigrants, mainly you Hispanics, okay? We've been telling you the white man is not your friend. We've been telling y'all that, man. Y'all gonna see that, though, man. Separating you from your kids. A lot of your kids are born here. They don't care about that. They gonna separate you anyway, man, because he's the devil, man. He took the land unjustly, and now he's dictating who can and can't be here. And we've been telling you, he's Esau. We've been telling you that for the longest, that a race war is gonna happen in this country, man. We've been saying that, right? That's why, let me read Revelation chapter 12, verse 12. Revelation 12 and 12. Demon next to me, man. Let me read Revelation 12 and 12. I always say, well, you know, like what we doing, like Chip said, occupying prophecy, pray, faith, keep the commandments to your best of your ability, and above all, the Most High already told us what's going to happen. So that's what he said, get ready for the battle, get your mind towards that, and be even as pilgrims upon the earth, meaning he's letting you know your life going to change. The things that you accustomed to, your comforts and the amenities that you have on a day-to-day basis, you're going to end up losing that.
Everybody.
Yeah. The scripture says, yeah, the world shall mourn. But only people that's going to be saved from those things in the end is his elect. Because we're the only ones that really know that the other brothers out there preaching the sincerity and truth. What's really going to happen, man? See? These other people out here, the American people are just out of their mind, man. I mean, now it's just at an all-time high, man. I mean, but the scripture does say that would happen, man. Matter of fact, let me read that. 2 Timothy, the 3rd chapter. People really under gross darkness, man. 2 Timothy, the 3rd chapter. This know also, that in the last days, perilous times shall come. See, this is all the spirit, man. She says in the last days, perilous times shall come. Troubling times, man. For men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud. And that's what I wanted to bring out. People are proud. The pride of life. Even though all these things are happening, they still proud, man. Okay, talking about they gonna make America great again. That's just foolish, man. America's beyond saving. Beyond saving. Number one, the way it was built was unjust. Rape, robbery, and murder. And then any society that allows homosexuality, transgender, that society morally is already finished. The Heavenly Father don't allow no kingdom like that to keep going on. And then your economy is already in debt. Ain't no jobs coming back here, man. And then you had Kmart, Sears, Walmart, Macy's closing, jobs being outsourced. Now you're talking about you want to build a wall. And you want to kick out the illegal, the Mexicans that's here. Was most of the jobs the American people don't want to do. Those are the people that do it. It's always the people at the bottom that keeps the society going. Okay, well this, see? So, and what's that going to lead to? A civil or race war. And then we're going to take things even further. Now you done pissed off the Eastern powers, which they already been pissed off. But he's adding fuel to the fire. Now Iran saying, you know what, we're going to get those missiles, man. Okay? We're going to blow them gutter rats off the face of the earth, them dudes over there in Israel, man. Russia, they not no friends with America. That whole Vladimir Putin and Trump relationship, that's going to fall, all right? They never been allies, man. That's foolishness, man. So World War III is imminent, which is going to be what? American Israel versus the entire planet Earth. Because NATO don't even want to deal with America like that because of Trump, man. They feel kind of iffy about this guy. All right? So let me read on. That's what the scripture says. For men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy. And we've seen that. Guys are cursing out their teachers, man. The men that taught you this knowledge, they starting to buck up against them. Guess what? You guys are just fulfilling prophecy. See, in times past, you would get angry at certain things, but you don't. You just allow things to play its course. Because why? You understand the latter end. And all you got to do is be patient and wait. That's all. So I'm saying, we don't get upset when people don't listen. Because the Bible already told you that they weren't going to listen. The Bible already told you that. It gives you examples. Multiple examples. But when the prophets came and taught, people didn't really hear them. Until the destruction happened, people, it's the same story all over again. There's nothing new under the sun. All right? People have the Bible in their hand, but they don't truly get it. You really think Jeremiah was looked at as a prophet in his time? No. Was Isaiah looked at as a prophet in his time? No. Was the world you English call Jesus, was he loved in his time? No, he was not. They killed him. The Son of the Most High. Because he told them the truth, man. Let me read on. Alright?
You always bring me back to reality.
Okay. Okay. That's good to hear. That's good to hear.
Alright. Take good care.
Alright. The Most High be with you. See, now she may be saved, man. That's a good sister, man. Well, maybe Most High may have mercy. I don't know. No, but, you know, it's our job, man. All right? We out here for who? The little ones. Ones that can receive it, man. And it does look like it's about to rain. But anyway, let me read on. I got time for that. Let me read on. It says, without natural affection, truth breakers. Woo! Who's that going into? Guys who fell out the truth, man. You a truth breaker, man. You a truth breaker. You fall out this work, take your hand off the plow, you're a truth breaker, man. And the Lord going to judge you for that, man. You actually tasted the kingdom, man. Unbelievable, man. The power and the rulership that we gonna receive, man. Joint heirs with Yahweh Shai. You gonna give that up for what? What's in this world? That's what we're fighting for. Nothing but this word, man. That's what Yahweh Shai said. Or let me just finish out this. False accusers, incontinent, fierce despisers of those that are good. And that's basically the people in the world. Everybody outside the truth is a despiser of those that do good. First of all, good is what? Keeping the commandments. Romans 7 and 12, man. Paul said the law is holy, just and good, man. Right? Having a form of godliness, denying the power thereof, such turn away. Now, let's talk about these other false Israelite groups. They have a form of godliness, but they deny the power. Oh, don't call on the name of the Lord. But we don't know the name. Are we going to get the name in the kingdom? Oh, the RFID chip is not the mark of the beast. Oh, you got to build your kingdom in America. See, they have a form of God, but you deny the power thereof, man. The Lord didn't say that. You're a false prophet. You're speaking things that's not contained in the book. And that's what the Bible calls filthy communication. That's filthy, man. To say you have to build your kingdom in America. To say that the name of the Lord don't matter. Every time Israel was in dire straits or problems, they called on that name. Quarantine, there we go. Read on. For of this sort, denying the power thereof, jumping out of verse 7, ever learning and never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. And that goes for 2/3 of our people. Ever learning, going to church every week, and never being able to come to the knowledge of the truth. Still don't know who you are, man. Still worshiping some white Jesus, man. Or if you're not worshiping a white Jesus, you're following the philosophy of America, man. Okay? You're stuck in Babylon, man. And if you stuck in this place of the image of the beast, follow his democracy and above all his new world order, the Most High gonna ask you, man. He's gonna destroy you, man. You got a lot of characters up there. That's what scripture said. We don't wrestle against flesh and blood, but principalities. You got all kind of demons out here, man. Alright? But you know what? We just gotta keep preaching, man. Scripture said, resist the devil and he shall flee from you. Alright? So, what did Yahweh Shai say? John chapter 4, verse 34. And I'm going to get to some World War III scriptures right after this. This is our only task right here. All right? John chapter 4, verse 34. It says, Yahweh Shai said unto them, my meat is to do the will of him that sent me and to finish. I'm going to read that point again. This is the point. John chapter 4, verse 34. Yahweh Shai said unto them, my meat is to do the will of him that sent me and to finish. It's about finishing. Finish the work, man. It's not about starting. It's about finishing. Matter of fact, let me see if I get that precept. See if I can find that precept real quick. Better. I feel like it's about to start pouring. Rocky, let me, there we go. Ecclesiastes 7 and 8. Ecclesiastes Ecclesiastes 7 and 8. So let me read that precept one more time and jump to that. John chapter 4, verse 34. It says, Yahweh Shah said unto them, my meat is to do the will of him that sent me, and to finish his work. Now, what's the work? He said in Matthew, the 22nd chapter, Luke, the 14th chapter. Record that, man. He said, what? To come out here on the highways and hedges, man, that my house might be filled. All right? So we got a job to do. And no demon could stop it. You know what I'm saying? No agent acting like they're on the phone or recording. This asshole right here in front of the camera. We got you numbered, man. We got you demons marked, man. Okay, you're not fooling anybody but yourself. Right? And that's why you got also agents on a comic board, which I'm going to get to that. Okay? Just like we said, the infiltration of the Messiah, taking him down, started from within. I'll read that precept one more time. Yahweh Shah said unto them, my meat is to do the will of him that sent me and to finish his work. So it's about finishing. That's why Solomon said, Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 8. Right, every week they send, every week is, and every time you blow these people, they always run. Like, I mean, it's crazy, man. It's really crazy, man. It's, you guys have got to come out here and record us, man. It's online, man. See, because they about to make their strategic strike, and they gonna come for brothers. We're already on Project Megiddo, the FBI list. The Hebrew Israelites is mentioned. So they have people following you, monitoring their online activities, monitoring when you come out here, but we don't care, right? Our life is for what? To finish this work, man. The Lord gonna justify us, man. Ecclesiastes 7 and 8. Better the end of a thing. It says, better is the end of a thing than the beginning thereof. See, so scripture says better the end of a thing. It's about finishing than the beginning thereof. And we've seen countless examples of men that came into this knowledge and fell out, man. Dishonorable servants, man. Who started building and couldn't finish. You're going to have your reward. You're going to have your fortune with the non-believers. Okay? That means you're a truce breaker, man. And death to you niggas, man, that took your hand off the plow. That's the only message we have for you. But Solomon said what? Ecclesiastes 7 and 8. Better is the end of a thing than the beginning thereof. And the patience in spirit is better than the proud in spirit. So, Scripture said better be patient than to be proud. We have nothing to be proud about, man. All of us are imperfect. Scripture says we all fall short. Alright? And the way we make up for our shortcomings is by doing the will of the Most High. What's His will? To gather the elect. Alright? And to condemn the society, man. Anything outside the circle of Israel, the elect of Israel, is going to be condemned. Point blank, period. 2/3 of the people going to die. And you other nations that don't die, you're going to slavery. Okay, that's ultimately the gospel. Alright? That's ultimately the gospel of Yahweh Shai. So like the scripture says, better the end of a thing than the beginning. That's why Paul said, and I'm going to jump to the next segment. We got to be soldiers, man. 2 Timothy chapter 4. This is a good scripture, man. It says, that's what Paul said after he was done. Verse 5. But watch thou all things, endure afflictions, man. Endure the trials, man. Endure the tribulations, man. Endure the temptations. You gotta endure it. You know, it sucks, of course it does. That's a part of your baptism.